Roger was a gold medalist in the 2008 Olympics in rowing, and he was the coxswain for the Canadian rowing team. But we've now taken him, so what do you do after the gold medal? Well, he was floundering a bit, and I helped him with his public speaking. Then he went back to the 2012 in London that got the silver medal. But he still needed help, and I've now worked with him, working from a low-level position in RBC to being a bank manager. And still working with him. The main thing we were working on this last week is how to more effectively manage his time. Because show me how a person's spending their free time, as I already said, and I'll tell you where they'll be in 10 years.
And the thing is that when you go through a session, how long are they, and what in a nutshell do you talk about?
Okay, the first thing I like the quote from Ralph Waldo Emerson. Everybody he would greet, he says, "What's become clear to you since we last met?" So I like to ask, what's become clear? We review a little bit about what happened the previous week. We take a look at where they want to go. We always do a visualization. I always take them through a guided imagery visualization. I have some clients once a week, some every 2 weeks. Every session is just around 47 minutes.
Not 47 and a half, right on, so 47.
47 minutes, that's, well, one of the things, somebody said to me, you rode your bike at age 70, I guess it was, from Victoria to Manitoba. And I said, yeah. He said, how'd you do that? I said, 47 minutes at a time. I would ride for 47 minutes and then take a break. Ride for 47 and take a break. That, by the way, is one of the things, oh, I tell you, I've got a client who, by the way, played hockey, Jordan Watt. He's a criminal defense lawyer. And he works hard. He's one of the top criminal defense lawyers in British Columbia. But I said, you have to work hard for 47 minutes and then take an 11-minute break. Because that allows your brain to relax and then flourish with new ideas. But we often say, how do I overcome procrastination? You take 11 minutes all out, and then take a break. 11 minutes, take a break.
Final thought.
No, 47 minutes, yeah, take a break.
Final thoughts, final thing that you want to, final impression you want to leave.
Everybody's capable of doing a lot more. Everybody is capable of doing a lot more. That's number one. Number two, and I always think about when I arrive in small towns, you can be the best in the world anywhere. I was just looking at Lee J. Leslie's shirt up there on the, and I remember Lee J. Leslie when he did have a Puckmasters franchise. Top hockey player. You can be the best in the world anywhere. It's just setting your mind to doing it.
Other than personal coach, Vic, is there any, do you have any other title as such? I know that, or should I just refer to you as a personal coach?
I'm a master coach in volleyball, and I still do volleyball clinics. I did a big camp in Zimbabwe.
Right.
So I sometimes I put down the title master coach.
And also, when did you coach the national team?
Oh, way back.
I know, 80s? That's, well, for me, that's not way back.
72.
Okay, 72. All right.
But that is way back.
And how long did you coach the national team for?
About 5 years.
Oh, and that was the national women's team?
That was the national women's team. I'm most proud of the fact that the Pan American Games, we went toe-to-toe with Brazil, and they beat us 3-1. We went toe-to-toe with Cuba, they beat us 3-1. Now, that was quite significant. And then we went toe-to-toe with the United States and beat them 3-1. And I was ready to retire then.
Appreciate it. Great job, as usual.